All right, next question. Why do headaches occur with LDN? So great question. I would assume mostly this happens sometimes when you're titrating up. We don't really want headaches to occur. So if headaches do occur, a lot of times we might need to have you at that lower dose for a longer period of time as we're trying to find your sweet spot, as Michelle was just kind of talking about. So when you're on your maintenance, you shouldn't be experiencing headaches. If you are, I would step back down to the dose previously and then stay on that. The other thing I will add with that is headaches could possibly be occurring because there is an endorphin kind of rush that's happening in your body when you're taking LDN, right? Because it's bound to the opioid receptor. And so it tricks the body into thinking, okay, I need to make more receptors and more endorphins. And so when it releases after about 6 hours of the half-life, you get this rush in, and that rush is what's thought to regulate the immune system, which could also maybe cause a headache if you're not titrating up appropriately. So there's a lot of factors with this. So I would want to know, how long have you been taking this dose? Is this new to you? What are you taking it for? But headaches can be common in the titration phase. Would you want to add anything, Michelle, to that?
Yeah, so sometimes people are using LDN for maybe they have Lyme disease or some type of a viral infection. And what we do see is a bloom with sometimes with LDN where you reduce the inflammation and you have a bloom of that virus or that fungus, even that yeast, and that can trigger a headache as well. So I'm actually looking at my notes, which is buried in my bag from the conference, because there was a provider that specifically addressed why the headaches happen with LDN, and there's a very specific mechanism of action, and it has to do with a lot of what you were saying with the changing of the endorphins and the endorphin receptors. But there was a bit more, and this was a conversation that Dr. Zielsdorf was having with Dr. Salibi, and it's in my notes, so I might disappear from the screen for 2 seconds. I might grab my notes really quick because that is, I will say the headache question is probably the second most common question that we get next to the vivid dreams.